Hi everybody, this is Jay Winnick, or as your kids know me as Mr. J. I am the co-producer and director of this evening's performance of Heroes and Villains on the Couch. I want to welcome you all and thank you all, first of all, for supporting the arts during this very difficult time. A few people I want to thank, first of all, Principal Yu at Portola for her support, without whose help we would not be able to be here, and of course the friends of Portola as well. I also want to thank Jane Ava, who is our amazing choreographer and musical director, and of course the incomparable jack of all trades, my co-producer, Farnaz Simontov, who's not only co-producer, but she is also the editor, the costumer, and the person who calls all of you parents and says, "Where are the recordings? Please send them." So thank you, Farnaz, for all of your incredible support of the arts. And most importantly, I want to thank you, the parents, who kept your children engaged during this incredibly difficult time, kept them enrolled in a program that hopefully they not only had fun with, but they learned something, and they realized that they could really step up to the plate and knock it out of the park, which is what they did. So again, incredibly thankful to all of you, grateful to your talented children. I cannot wait to meet them all in person coming this fall, and hopefully this will be our final virtual performance of any kind. I hope you all please enjoy Heroes and Villains on the Couch.
Dr. Cricket, Dr. Jiminy Cricket. I'm pleased to welcome you to the Blue Fairy Clinic, where we offer a variety of therapy options to help you become your best self. Our goal is to help improve our clients' quality of life by helping them access that small voice that they sometimes don't listen to, their conscience. We hope to help our clients see right from wrong. At the Blue Fairy Clinic, we offer both individual and group therapy options to help maximize our clients' true potential. We accept all insurance plans. No insurance, no problem. We have a very affordable sliding fee scale.
What brings you in today, Miss Hannigan?
I don't know. I'm at a crossroads.
How so?
One minute I'm living my life the way I want, and the next minute I'm saving that brat's life. I don't know what to think anymore.
Tell me more
about
that.
Well, you see, Doc, I run an orphanage, and between you and me, wait. This is confidential, right?
There are some exceptions to confidentiality.
Yeah, what are they?
If you pose a danger to yourself or others, I have to make a report. Oh, also, if you disclose any kind of child—
It's been nice knowing that. I'll see you later.
Little girls everywhere I turn, I can see them. Little girls, night and day, I eat, sleep, and breathe them. Some women are dripping with diamonds. Some women are dripping with pearls. Lucky me, lucky me. Look at what I'm dripping with, little girls. Someday I'll step on their freckles. Some night I'll straighten their curls. Send a flood, send a flu, anything that you can do to little girls.
Brooke and Violet. Interesting names. Are you sisters?
We are not sisters.
We are best friends, but she doesn't understand that I'm better than her at everything.
How could that be possible? I always get my way. Don't forget, I'm richer than you.
Why don't you start by telling me how you met?
You were both selected for a contest. It's important for you to know that I am a natural born winner. I have never lost at anything. In fact, I have 263 trophies and medals on a variety of different activities, from kung fu to cheerleading. I'm most proud of being the junior world champion gum chewer, a title I earned by chewing the same piece of gum for 3 straight months.
To be clear, I wasn't selected. My daddy made sure I received a golden ticket by instructing all the workers at his peanut shelling factory to unwrap thousands of Wonka bars until they got me a golden ticket. I always get what I want.
So you're upset at each other because you both want the prize from this contest?
That simpleton Charlie won!
Well, it's a fact of life that you can't always get what you want.
That's rubbish. I want it.
I want a bean feast. Friends and donuts and fruitcake with melons. So good you can donuts. Give them to me. Now, I want a party with rainbows and laughter. I want a ton of ice cream. And if I don't get the things I am after, I'm gonna scream. Works. I want the whole works. Presents and prizes and sweets and surprises of all shapes and sizes. And now, don't care how, I want it now. Don't care how, I want it now.
Bad nut.
Tell me a little bit about yourself, Mr. Beetlejuice.
It's just Beetlejuice, no mister. First off, I'm 600 years old and you should know that I'm dead. I attended Juilliard and I'm a graduate of Harvard Business School. I've traveled quite extensively and I very much enjoy living through the Black Plague.
What are some of your hobbies?
I love scaring people out of their pants and pulling pranks. I also enjoy watching comedies. My favorite one is The Exorcist. I've watched it 167 times.
So, it sounds like you are happiest when others are in pain.
Yes, but I'm not going to lie. It wears away at me because I'm invisible.
You're invisible when you're me. There's no one to see my true. If they could look up, they'd see, hey, somebody's on the roof. God, it's mortifying. What's the point of even trying? 'Cause now I'm trapped with no escape. Banish, disavow, I vanish like a cloud of dirty hair. Survey. Nobody said life's fair. I guess they will never see the demon who isn't there. You're invisible when you're me.
I just feel like I'm constantly disappointing my mother.
I just don't see why you would say that. I've been nothing but supportive. I've taught you everything I know, my darling. I've taught you how to be selfish, ruthless, and vengeful.
That's just it. No matter how hard I try, I can't be as evil as you. I mean, I love coming up with wicked schemes and casting spells, but every time I tell you what I've done, it just isn't good enough.
Lefson, why do you think Mal feels this way?
What am I supposed to do? Constantly praise her for what she should be doing anyways? Nobody ever did that for me.
So you're saying you've had a difficult past?
If being treated like an outcast and having your wings cut off to reduce your power is difficult, then yes, I would say I've had a very difficult past.
This must have been a terrible experience for you.
Yes, I was quite heartbroken, but no matter. I've had my revenge, and I will continue to get my revenge until the end of time. And for my darling daughter, I have a few words.
Look at you, look at me, I don't know who to be, mother. Is it wrong? Is it right? Be a thief in the night, mother. Tell me what to do.
I was once like you, my child, slightly insecure. Argued with my mother too, thought I was mature. But I put my heart aside, and I use my head. Now I think it's time you learn what dear old mama said. Don't you wanna be evil like me? Don't you wanna be mean? Don't you wanna make mischief your daily routine? Well, you can spend your life attending to the my whole life long to do the worst I can. Clawed my way to victory, built my master plan. Now the time has come, my dear, for you to take your place. Promise me you'll try to be an absolute disgrace. Don't you want to be evil like me? Don't you want to be cruel? Don't you want to be nasty and brutal and cool? And when you grab that wand, that's when your reign begins. Who wants an evil queen without a sack of sin? Don't you want to be heartless and hardened as stone? Don't you want to be finger-licking evil to the bone? This is not for us to ponder, this was preordained. You and I shall rule together, freedom soon regain. Mistress of the universe, powerful and strong. Daughter, hear me, help me, join me, hope you sing on. And we're gonna be evil, it's true, never gonna think twice.
And we're gonna be spiteful.
Yes, spiteful. Nice. In just an hour or two, our future's safe and sure. This mother-daughter act is going out on tour. If you want to be evil and awful and free, then you should thank your lucky star that you were born the girl you are, the daughter of an evilicious queen.
Well, my mother, Mama Hub, was a pirate and trained me in the ways of piracy. Unfortunately, I wasn't very good at it. My mother was never happy with me. She said I was pitiful. I didn't have any friends. The best friend was a stuffed bear.
That sounds so sad. That must have been very hard for you.
It was, but I decided then and there that I would have to be the most ruthless pirate to sail the seven seas. I would never be ostracized again.
Is that how you see yourself?
I did. That is until that menace Peter Pan came into the picture.
Peter Pan?
Indeed. Have you never heard of him? He's a boy who never grows up. He lives in Neverland and gets away with whatever he wants because he's a child. He kidnaps kids from their homes and acts like it's heroic.
That sounds so terrible. Did he do something to you?
He did. He thought it'd be hilarious to cut off my hand and feed it to a monstrous crocodile. That's how I got this hook. Can't you see, Doc? I'm the victim here. But I vowed on that day, revenge would be mine.
My dear prince and princess, your offer is meaningless. Don't give a damn about your rank. The jewel in your sack, well, it isn't worth jack. I should make you fools go off the plank. Your riches will fill other pirates with glee. Well, none of those pirates are me. Singing yo ho, keep your jewels divine. Yo ho, and your manners are fine. Kids, even more precious than rum in a stein is revenge, revenge, revenge is gonna be mine. Revenge, revenge, revenge is gonna be mine.
Who?
Wait till the second verse, love. I savage and pillage, I crippled each village. My conquest I'm justly proud of. Each time that I plunder, I leave to asunder. A pirate's life is one to love. And yet my heart's hard and as hard as a rock. Won't rest, I've skinned me a croc. Singing yo-ho, you can beg, bring wine, but yo-ho, you are wasting your time. That croc, my hand, wanna tear his spine. Revenge, revenge, revenge is gonna be mine. Revenge, revenge, revenge is gonna be mine.
Wait, you want revenge on a crocodile for taking your hand?
Yeah, I'm afraid he did more than that. Once I sailed toward the horizon, why my friend happiness waiting? Until that croc destroyed my life and filled me with hate uninvading. Some say let it go, but I say hell no. I'm finally on the right path. Soon the dark one will feel the fire of this pirate's wrath.
Did you see the dark one? I know why you can't find him. He's here in our inpatient unit.
Bloody hell.
I can let you have a session with him if you promise not to harm him. Perhaps you can resolve some of your issues.
I love, we got you. Have one last drink, mate. Then we got a date with destiny. Singing yo ho, I will slaughter this swine. Yo ho, must be fate's design. At last, our tales will again intertwine. Revenge, revenge, revenge is gonna be mine. Oh, it's gonna be. Oh, it's gonna be. Oh, it's gonna be mine. Oh, it's gonna be. Oh, it's gonna be. Oh, it's gonna be mine.
Hello, Wednesday. How are you doing today?
Should I lie down?
No, there's no need.
Well, I was on my way to being perfectly bad, and then I met this guy, and now I just don't know what to do with myself.
Tell me more about this guy.
Well, he's the opposite of who I am. He's disgustingly happy and nice.
What's wrong with happy and nice?
You know how I am. I'm obsessed with death. My role model was my great aunt, who was burned at the stake as a witch in 1706. And I like setting fires. My biggest joy in life is torturing my brother Pugsley. But you know what happened yesterday? I was torturing Pugsley and I did not feel joy. For the first time in my life, I thought, hey, maybe this is cruel. Ever since I met this guy, it just feels like I'm being pulled in a new direction. I don't have a sunny disposition. I'm not known for being too amused. My demeanor's locked in one position. See my face, I'm enthused. Suddenly, however, I've been puzzled. Bunny rabbits make me want to cry. All my ambitions have been muzzled. And I think I know why. I'm being pulled in a new direction. But I think I like it. I think I like it. I'm being pulled in a new direction. Through my painful pursuit, somehow birdies took root. All the things I detested, impossibly cute. God, what do I do? Mother always said, be kind to strangers, but she doesn't know what they destroy. I can feel the clear and present dangers when she learns that the boy has got me pulled in a new direction. But I think I like it. I'm being pulled in a new direction. But this feeling I know is impossible, so I'll confide that I've tried, but I can't let it go. It's disgustingly true. Pulse, pulse, pulse. Puppy dogs with droopy faces, unicorns with dancing mice, sunrise in wide open spaces, Disney World, I'll go there twice. Butterflies and picnic lunches, bunches of chrysanthemums, lollipops and pillow fights, and Christmas Eve, sugar plums, string quartets and chia pets, and afternoon banana splits, angels watching as I sleep, and Liberace's greatest hits has got me pulled in a new direction. They keep insisting I'll stop resisting. Just watch me pulled in a new direction. I should stay in the dark, not obey every spark. But the boy has a bite better far than his bark. And you'll bet I'll bite too. Do what's truly taboo. As I'm pulled in a new direction.
My natural tendencies.
Has that not worked out for you?
It was working out great. And then walks in a patient who likes the pain. I mean, he literally enjoyed the pain that I inflicted on him. I was thrown completely out of my element. I lost my mind, and here I am.
When I was younger, just a bad little kid, my mama noticed funny things I did, like shooting puppies with a BB gun. I'd poison guppies, and when I was done, I'd find a pussycat and bash in its head. That's when my mama said...
What did she say?
She said, my boy, I think someday you'll find a way to make your natural tendencies pay. You'll be a dentist. You have a talent for causing things pain. Son, be a dentist. People will pay you to be inhumane. Your temperament's wrong for the priesthood. And teaching would suit you still less.
Son, be a dentist. You'll be a success.
Here he is, folks, the leader of the plaque.
Watch him suck up that gas. Oh my god!
He's the dentist, and he'll never ever be any good. Who wants their teeth done by the Marquis de Sade?
Oh, that hurts! You're not numb! That's enough! Open wide, here I come! I am your dentist!
Your dentist!
I enjoy the career that I think.
Love it!
I am your dentist!
Love it.
When I start extracting those molds,
oh my goodness,
the girls will be screaming like holy rodents. And though it may cause my patients distress, somewhere in heaven above me, I know that my mom is proud of it.
Oh, mama.
today?
Oh, where to begin? I've been told I have anger management issues just because I want what I want. And what I want is my slippers.
Your slippers?
Yes, my ruby slippers. Well, they did belong to my sister. Of course, she got everything that was supposed to be mine in the first place. The ruby slippers, made of a munchkin land, where she had exclusive rights to terrify the people. Just because she was older than me. Well, not anymore, my pretty, not anymore.
That's interesting. Tell me more about your childhood. What was your mother like?
Well, let's see. My mother was embarrassed by my green skin, so she turned me into a social outcast. I wasn't even allowed to play with the other children. My nanny finally convinced her to let me play with the other children in the neighborhood. They did nothing but bully me constantly. I was finally accepted into shiz and had some hope for a new start. But who did I get stuck with? That dreadfully joyous Glinda. Don't get me wrong, we became friends at first. And then I realized that my green skin would always make me the outcast. I decided to embrace it and use my power to get everything that should be mine. And I will never forgive her for giving my slippers away to that clueless prissy Dorothy.
It must have been very hard to have your friend betray you like that.
To say the least, I will get her, my pretty. I will get them all.
Something has changed within me. Something is not the same. I'm through with playing by the rules of someone else's game. Too late for second guessing. Too late to go back to sleep. It's time to trust my instincts. Close my eyes and leap. It's time to try defying gravity. I think I'll try defying gravity, and you can't pull me down. I'm through accepting limits, 'cause someone says they're so. Some things I cannot change, but till I try, I'll never know. Too long I've been afraid of losing love, I guess I've lost. Well, if that's love, it comes, and much too high a cost. I'd sooner buy defying gravity. Kiss me goodbye, I'm defying gravity, and you can't pull me down. So if you can't find me, look up to the western sky. As someone told me lately, everyone deserves a chance to fly. And if I'm flying so low, at least I'm flying free. To those who'd ground me, take a message back from me. Tell them how I'm defying gravity. I'm flying high, defying gravity, and soon I'll match them now. And nobody in all of Oz, no wizard that there is or was, is ever gonna bring me.
Good day. The pleasure is all yours.
What brings you in today?
I strongly believe that I should be Sultan of Agrabah.
Doesn't Agrabah already have a Sultan?
Yes, But I'm a powerful sorcerer. Therefore, the throne should be mine. If it hadn't been for that street rat Aladdin, I would have been sultan. He ruined everything. And now I'm in the depths of depression.
What can you do to help yourself?
I need to find another magic lamp and be rid of Prince Abubu. Then everything will be fine. I'm Jafar. Yes, it is me, but not as you know me. Leave my lips and come to grips with reality. We must go back to the past, because my life just couldn't last. Say hello to your future Sultan, that's me. So Ali turns out to be merely Aladdin. Just a con, need I go on, take it from me. His personality flaws give me adequate cause. To compare myself to him is fair, so my prospects gain a certain flair. All of your assets will ultimately be mine at the end. Whoopee! So long, ex-Prince Ali.
Session. Who would like to share first?
What is it that you want to know?
Well, Portola, one thing you three all have in common is your love and need for money. Why don't you start with what it is about riches that is so attractive to you?
For me, of course. It's not just about money. High in fashion and style are the utmost importance.
Thinking back to your childhood, when did this start for you?
As a little girl.
We'll get to you in a moment.
All I ever wanted to do was to make my mother proud. You see, she was the proprietor of a very successful and very famous fur shop. I was always disappointed in my criticism of the way in which the animals were treated. And then one day she just disappeared. I made it my life quest to honor her, so that she would come back.
Can anyone else relate to this sense of abandonment?
Well, I don't know what happened to my parents, but I've had to fend for myself my whole life. And let me tell you something. I may be a pickpocket, but that doesn't mean I ain't smart. I figured out a way to take care of myself.
I had my own little girl once. I fell in love and was married at 18, and we had a child. And one day on my daughter's second birthday, my good-for-nothing husband of mine took her to the aquarium and they never came back. How's that for abandonment?
So sorry for what you've all been through.
Well, we don't need them anyway. We have our own way of being successful. Money's what's important.
That's right. It's better to live on Easy Street.
It ain't fair how we scratch for 3 or 4 bucks while she gets 4 bucks.
The little brat. It ain't fair, this here life is driving me nuts. While we get peanuts, she's living fat.
Maybe she holds that key, that little lady,
to getting more bucks
instead of less.
Maybe we quit the game with something shady.
Where does that put us?
I'll give you one guess.
Yes!
Easy Street.
And
yes.
to the Blue Fairy Clinic, King George. Are you finding the accommodations acceptable?
You are heretofore to refer to me as Your Highness. There is a simple explanation for why I have been placed here. The usurpers are staging a coup d'etat! I'm not insane! Those intrepid fools had the audacity to place me in a straitjacket.
It says here that you have a history of mental illness, but you've been stable for 12 years. Has anything happened recently to increase your stress?
Surely you jest. I'm the monarch of Great Britain. Have you not heard about what those traitors in the colonies did to me? I don't care if it was 15 years ago! They must be taught a lesson.
You say, the price of my love is not a price that you're willing to pay. You cry, and your tear which you hurl in the sea when you see me go by. It's so sad. Remember we made an arrangement when you went away. Now you're making me mad. Remember, despite our estrangement, I'm your man. You'll be back soon, you'll see. You'll remember you belong to me. You'll be back, time will tell. You'll remember that I served you well. Oceans rise, empires fall. We have seen each other through it all. And when push comes to shove, I will send a fully armed battalion to remind you of my love. Da 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 da. Da 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 da. You say our love is draining and you can't go on. You'll be the one complaining when I am gone. And no, don't change the subject, 'cause you're my favorite subject. My sweet, submissive subject. My loyal, royal subject. Forever and ever and ever and ever and ever. You'll be back like before. I will fight the fight and win the war. For your love, for your praise. And I'll love you till my dying days. When you're gone, I'll go mad. So don't throw away this thing we had. 'Cause when push comes to shove, I will kill your friends and family to remind you of my love. Da 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 da. Da 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 ya da 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 ya da 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 ya da 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 da. Everybody, da 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 ya da 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 ya da 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 ya da 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 da. Da, ya, da.
Good afternoon. What brings you in today?
Well, I guess you could say I'm experiencing some of a crisis.
How so?
I've always believed that I'm the purpose of all.
And why is being beautiful so important to you?
Beauty needs a power, and without power, you're nothing.
And why are you having a crisis right now?
I was speaking with my mirror and you told me that there is one more fair than me.
You were speaking with your mirror? Do you often hear voices that other people don't hear?
What are you implying?
Well, I'm just clarifying what you said. Your mirror told you this?
That's not your concern. I need to get rid of this fair maiden.
I think
think it might be best for you to stay here with us for a while. Would you like some pillows to sit on?
I am fine. I am not a child.
Welcome to the Blue Fairy Clinic, Mr. Farquhar.
Lord! It's Lord Farquhar.
I apologize, Lord Farquhar. How can I help you today?
I am just beside myself. I am about to lose my throne as a ruler of Duloc because I must marry a princess. Just because I'm not of royal blood. But please, understand. My mother could have been the queen, but she chose to marry my useless father instead.
Tell me more about your father.
Well, he was a grumpy miner who spent most of his time at work. He wasn't around very much at all. And even when he was, he didn't talk very much.
Would you say that your father was emotionally unavailable?
Who needs emotions when you can have power? That's why I sit out to rule the lands. I won't let anyone push me around.
My daddy was a miner, so he wasn't much around. Foraging for diamonds, all I spent underground. Daddy didn't talk much, he barely said hello. He simply muttered, hi-ho! And off to work he go, Daddy was grumpy. My mommy was a princess who left her crown behind. Daddy was her true love, so mama didn't mind. Ah, never knew my mama, but she could have been a queen. She married way beneath her knee, I mean. Oh, Daddy's bed was lumpy, so mommy couldn't sleep. Daddy built a new one, so tall and so steep. 25 mattresses slept upon. One night she rolled over, and mama was gone. So Daddy was grumpy, and me and my old man, a tale as old as dirt, a bitter distant father in a tiny undershirt. Daddy up and left me good as dead. Now he lives in squalor, sleeping 7 to a bed.
Good afternoon, Dr. Facilier.
You can just call me Shadow Man.
Okay. What are we doing today?
I seem to be at a crossroads.
How so?
For many years, I've believed that power comes from sorcery and dark magic. I'm starting to realize that true, meaningful power comes from wealth.
And why is power so important to you?
Well, you see, I'm descended from royalty. But all of that was ripped away from me as a child, and I grew up in poverty, with the rich either treating me with disrespect or ignoring me altogether. I vowed to become powerful through sorcery and dark magic. Let me tell you about my friends on the other side, and then you'll understand.
Don't you disrespect me, little man. Don't you derogate or deride. You're in my world now, not your world. And I've got friends on the other side.
Just an echo, gentlemen. A little something we have here in Louisiana. A little parlor trick, don't worry.
Sit down at my table. Put your mind at ease. If you relax, it will enable me to do anything I please. I can read your future. I can change around some too. I look deep into your heart and soul.
You don't have a soul, do you, Ursula?
Make your wildest dreams come true. I got voodoo, I got voodoo, I got things I ain't even tried. And I've got friends on the other side. He's got friends on the other side. The cards will sell. The
past, the present, and the future as well. The cards. The cards. Just take three. Take a little trip into your future with me. Now you young men are from across the sea. You come from two long lines of royalty. I'm a royal myself on my mother's side. Your lifestyle's high, but your funds are low. You need to marry a little honey whose daddy got dough. Mom and dad cut you off, huh, playboy? Sad but true. Now you gotta get hitched. Hitching tires, you know? You just wanna be free. Hop from place to place. Freedom takes green. Green. It's the green, it's the green, it's the green you need. And when I look into your future, it's the green that I see. On you, little man, I don't waste much time. You've been pushed around all your life. You've been pushed around by your mother and your sister and your brother. And if you was married, you'd be pushed around by your wife. But in your future, you, I see, is exactly the man you always wanted to be. Come on, boys, shake my hand. Won't you shake a poor sinner's hand? Yes. Are you ready? Are you ready? Transformation Central. Transformation Central. Transmogrification Central. Can you feel it? You're changing, you're changing, you're changing. All right, I hope you're satisfied. But if you ain't, don't blame me. You can blame my friends on the other side.
Good afternoon, Miss Ursula. What brings you in today?
To be very candid, I'm quite despondent over my living conditions.
What's the problem with your living conditions?
You see, I have been exiled by my own brother, King Triton, and banished to the remains of the Leviathan line with a garden of wreathing polyps.
Polyps?
Yeah, you see, I use my powers to help people. But, as you know, everything comes at a price. The polyps are the souls of merfolk who had come to me for help, but found themselves unable to fulfill their side of the bargain. I've had no choice but to claim them as my own and add them to my collection.
That's quite disturbing. Have you tried being kind instead?
Kind? Where was the kindness when I was bullied for my appearance for all those years? Not just by strangers, but disparaged and mistreated by my own family. I'll show you kind, you little troll!
I admit that in the past I've been nasty. They were kidding when they called me, well, a witch. But you'll find that nowadays I've mended all my ways, repented, seen the light, and made a switch. True, yes. And I fortunately know a little magic. It's a talent that I always have possessed. And here lately, please don't laugh, I use it on behalf of the miserable, the lonely and depressed, pathetic, poor, fortunate souls in pain, in need. This one longing to be thinner, this one wants to get the girl, and do I help them? Yes, indeed. Those poor, unfortunate souls, so sad, so true. They come flocking to my cauldron crying, spells, Ursula, please, and I help them? Yes, I do. Now it's happened once or twice. Someone couldn't pay the price, and I'm afraid I've had to rake them across the coals. Yes, I've had the odd complaint, but on the whole, I've been a saint. To those poor, unfortunate souls.
She's otherwise occupied. How may I be of assistance?
I'm not really sure. One minute I'm getting married in Andalusia, and the next I somehow end up in a completely different world.
sounds like quite the predicament.
It is. I don't know how to get back. I would do anything to get back.
Well, I think I might be able to help you with that. What kind of deal are you willing to make? Perhaps we can come to some sort of arrangement?
How can you help me?
I know exactly what it'll take. But remember, everything comes at a price. In your case, it will take a true love's kiss.
A true love's kiss?
Prince I'm hoping comes with this. That's what brings ever after rings so happy. That's the reason we need lips so much, for lips are the only things that touch. So to spend a life of endless bliss, to find who you love through a true comes with this. That's what brings ever after rings so happy. That's the reason we need lips so much, for lips are the only things that touch. So to spend a life of endless bliss, just find who you what true love's kiss.
Welcome to the Blue Fairy Clinic. How may I be of assistance?
Lately, I've been struggling to understand the true meaning of heroism.
Perhaps that's because heroism is for the weak.
The weak?
Yes, indeed. True power comes from negotiating skills.
You know, you remind me of my Uncle Hades. You're not a therapist, are you? Wait a minute, aren't you my cousin Ursula? What have you done with Dr. Cricket? Is that Dr. Cricket?
Thank you. I know I would have gotten out if you hadn't found me.
And thank you. I came here to figure out how to stop being such a clumsy goofball, but I figured out that when I focus, control my strength, and analyze the situation, I can be victorious.
I'm glad I could help. As for you, I'm thinking our inpatient unit is the best way to help you. You'll be staying with us for a nice long while.
Ha! We shall see about that.
I have often dreamed of a far-off place where a hero's welcome will be waiting for me, and the crowds will cheer when they see my face, and a voice keeps saying, "This is where I'm meant to be." I will find my way. I can go the distance. I'll be there someday. If I can be strong, I know every mile will be worth my while. I would go most anywhere to feel like I belong.
some of your concerns with each other. Perhaps it'll be helpful to know that you are not alone.
I don't think anyone can understand what I've been through. I've been treated as an outcast and banished by my own brother.
Can anyone else relate to this?
I can. I know all about sibling rivalry and being the outcast.
I certainly understand what that's like. I too was treated as an outcast and left for dead.
I suppose I managed to turn myself into an outcast and insisting on being the favorite of all.
I can relate to that. It's not easy being the best. I guess I did put myself in danger of being so competitive.
Listening to y'all is really eye-opening. Mom, I don't think I want to be as evil as you. I think it's good to be smart and sneaky, but it's also important to be compassionate. I think what I need, what we all need, is a hero.
Where have all the good men gone? And where are all the gods? Where's the streetwise Hercules to fight the rising odds? Isn't there a white knight upon the fiery steed? Late at night I toss and I turn. And I dream of what I need. I need a hero.
If I can go from zero to hero, anyone can.
Bless my soul, Herb was on a roll. Person of the week in every Greek Olympian poll. What a pro, Herb could stop the show. More than that monster, any talking is our role. He was no one, a zero, zero. Now he's a monster, he's a hero. He was a kid with his eyebrow hat. Zero the hero, no sound bad. Zero the hero, just like that. When he smiled, the girls went wild with woo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo. And he slapped his face on every face, on every boss. From appearance jeans and royalties, our hair can't catch the burn. Now you all reach and pay the tea, and tell you what celebration is earned. Say amen, there he goes again, sweet and undefeated, and awesome 10 for 10. Folks line up just to watch the flex, and the turban cap and cap and hair pretty dead. Hurry, he comes, he's cheesy bonkers, hiding the girl with a growing bonkers. He shows the pops, he brings his phone. Zero the hero, a major hunk. Zero the hero, and who would have thought? Who was the gladiator? Hercules, whose hair needs a radiator. Hercules, is he bold? No one's braver. Is he sweet or fiercely?
Everybody has good in them. Nobody's all good or all bad. With love, compassion, and understanding, we can all find happiness. That doesn't mean we will be happy all of the time. It means that it's okay for us to have feelings, even if we feel bad sometimes. What matters is feeling understood.
We will all